Hi viewers, in this video I will show you a toy alignment system that I designed years ago for myself. I will use it on my Honda Desel 1993 to give you a basic description on how I checked and adjust the toe-in on cars.
As you can see, I built this toe-in guide kit. The four guide assemblies are installed on each of the four wheels. The aft section on the four assemblies is adjustable. This makes it suitable for different rim sizes. The bungee cords are used to hold the guides in place on steel or alloyed wheels. To obtain accurate measurements, I built my guide plates with extruded aluminum that had a shape compatible with my design. Before working on my toe-in alignment, I made a basic research to find the front and the rear information concerning the toe specs. I also looked for the track width because many cars are built with positive or negative track width. I used these values to prepare my setup and to evaluate the gauge of the shims that I could use. To set the car in place, I parked it on a leveled surface. The four tires must have the same size and must be inflated to specs. Sometimes a tire must be repositioned in a way the wheel weight is not obstructing any guide plate. If you don't have a steering wheel holder, you can use two reverse long clamps to hold and center the steering wheel in place. On many cars, a well-calibrated steering angle sensor sends the rotation angle to an electronic module. When the data is available, I use my OBD2 scanner to adjust the steering wheel to the 0° position. To set and install an assembly, I loosen the bolts and I adjust the movable guide plate on the rim flange. When the position is good, I tighten the bolts and I install the assembly. To secure the guide plates, I simply hold the assembly in place with a bungee cord. The four assemblies are different and they are installed on dedicated wheels. The following step shows how I install the string between the forward guide plate and the aft guide plate on the left side of the car. The tension of the string was adjusted when I attached it on the low V-groove attachment. After, I continued with the setup on the right-hand side of the car. The second string was installed with the same tension as the first one. So far, I was satisfied with the overall positioning. I can use two string positions with my guides. I selected the lower one, so I was able to open the car doors. The toe-in specs for my Delsol were in millimeters. But I prefer fraction of degrees because it's easy to convert them in units that fit the rim size instead of the tire size. To actually measure a toe-in or a toe-out correction on a wheel, I can use a ruler, a small shim, or a feeler gauge. As shown on my drawing, I had to use 5mm shims on the rear guides to compensate the difference between the rear track width and the front track width. With the first 5mm shim installed on the rear left side, I measured the space on the adjacent guide plate. The total was 7mm. I subtracted the 5mm shim and I obtained 2mm. That result met the Honda specifications. After, I continued with the front wheel on the left side. To adjust the toe-in, I inserted the 1.5mm shim between the string and the forward guide plate. This shim was fine and it corrected the position of the string that was aligned with the next guide plate. I rechecked the rear wheel and the spacing was still good. I went on the other side of the car and I installed the other 5mm shim on the rear guide plate. I repeated the measuring operations and I got the same 2mm that respected the specifications. I went to the front wheel and I needed to add two 1.5mm shims to align the string with the next guide plate. I rechecked the rear wheel measurement and it was still very close to the 2mm spacing. There was too much toe-in on the front wheels. I decided to adjust the toe-in on each front wheel as close as possible to 0mm. Because I had the front wheels to adjust, I only removed the front guide assemblies and the front wheels. On this view, you can observe the treads of the tie rod. With a metric ruler, I measured a 1.5mm pitch per rotation. I used that reference to adjust the tie rod. I used a 14mm wrench to screw the tie rod 1/3 of a turn. I did not lock it to keep it adjustable. After, I installed the wheel and I removed the jack. On the other side, I removed the front wheel, but the tie rod and the lock nut were completely frozen. At least, it was a good occasion to show that I have to use a torch once in a while. On this wheel, I had two shims and I needed more corrections. To reduce the toe-in, the tie rod was screwed two-thirds of a turn without locking it. Again, when the adjustment was made, I installed the wheel and I removed the jack. When both of the front wheels were on the floor, I reinstalled the front toe guides and the strings. I checked the toe-in spacing on the front wheels and they were very close to 0 mm. If required, I was still able to adjust the tie rod by hand from under the car. I was satisfied with the result and I removed all the guides. The front of the car was jacked up again to remove the front wheels. The tie rod lock nuts were tightened and the torque was set to 40 foot-pounds. The wheels were reinstalled and the torque was set to Honda specifications. After the toe alignment, I made a road test to make sure that the car was handling properly, and the result was quite good.
I hope you like the presentation and you're learning something new. Even if you are using another method, you have to rely on company specs to check and adjust the alignment on your vehicle. So take your time and find the measurements before you begin any DIY jobs.